Now to I-8. Indiana legislators are pushing for harsher punishments on predators trafficking children.
Yeah, trafficking is an issue that's really surging across the state of Indiana right now. I-8's Jasmine Miner joining us now. She's been digging into how people want leaders to take action, Jasmine.
Well, guys, just last week, a federal judge sentenced a Texas man to 23 years in prison for using Instagram to sexually exploit a 14-year-old girl in Hamilton County. Well, it's Something Not Today, which is an organization that helps fund areas of restoration for victims of sexual violence or trafficking, says is an epidemic. Well, 157 human trafficking cases reported in Indiana in just 2019. That number is on the rise, and Not Today is calling on Indiana leaders to make sure it's that much harder for a predator to get away.
What's it going to take?
You, the legislators, say, let's make Indiana a no trafficking zone.
To keep our Indiana children safe.
Nobody intercepts them when they're children. That's the problem.
It's a mission Linda Reich, president of Not Today, testified in support of by calling for the reintroduction of a bill that would increase penalties for predators.
There's no question that how things have been set up typically across the country, it protects adults.
And allow victims to give a video statement instead of having to be physically present in a courtroom with their attacker.
People think that, oh, this just happens in, you know, urban communities, you know, throwaway kids or whatever. No, this is alive and well in Zionsville, in Carmel.
An amendment that was added in the Senate that basically said that if I was purchasing somebody and I didn't know that they were 18, I could use that as a defense and not be charged with a harsher crime.
Representative Wendy McNamara says she couldn't give the sign off last year with that amendment to get it through the Senate, but try again, she says.
They're not afraid to cross our borders and come into our state.
There's borders, and then there's the internet.
70 million files that were out there just last year of children being abused sexually by adults.
That's according to the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children.
Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat are predators learning how to take advantage of them.
Not Today's advocacy director, Leah Reich, has a background working in tech and says parents have to be aware predators are more pervasive than one might think.
This issue knows no demographic. Could be the man in his basement, but it could also be the man making $300,000 and a stable job with three kids who is trading this material online.
And they say it's time for more action.
Shame on us as a country if we as adults do not start convicting and prosecuting the perpetrators.
Well, Representative McNamara tells me the new bill will be brought to the floor once again in January. Not Today says they want to help parents know what to look for when it comes to predators online or in person. We've got some resources for you right now online at wishtv.com. I'm Jasmine Miner for Wish TV, wishtv.com, and follow us on Facebook.